Let's discuss about Pascal's principle of pressure distribution. This principle is about how pressure applied at one point in a fluid is distributed throughout its volume. Let's write down the statement of Pascal's principle. It states that the pressure applied at one point in an enclosed fluid body is transmitted, or we can also write distributed, uniformly to every part of the fluid body or to every part of the fluid. This is the statement we use. And here we are talking about enclosed fluid. That means we are mainly talking about a static fluid in the reference frame of consideration. So we can say at any one point, if some pressure is applied, it is transmitted or distributed uniformly to every part of the fluid. Let's discuss a situation to understand it better. In this situation, we are given with a container completely filled with a liquid, and it is closed with the help of a cork at its mouth. Now, in this situation, it is not open to atmosphere anywhere. So, if we consider a point A in the fluid body, which is located at a depth H below the top layer of the liquid, in this situation, we can simply write pressure at point A is given as H rho G, because this pressure is due to the weight of the liquid which exists above the point A. In this situation, the pressure is H rho G. Now, we'll see what will happen if the cork of this container at its mouth is open. Let's see what will happen in this situation. Now, you can see as the cork is opened, now the free surface of liquid is in contact with the atmosphere, and atmosphere will exert a pressure P atmosphere at this point. Now, we can imagine the situation if a spherical liquid molecules here will experience a pressure from atmosphere. These will transfer the pressure to the other contact particles, or the other particles in contact with these liquid particles due to the contact reaction. And continuously, the pressure will be transmitted to every point of the fluid body. Now, in this situation, again, the point A is considered, which we have seen here, which is at a depth H below the top layer of the liquid. So, in this situation, pressure at point A, which was H rho G, due to the weight of liquid above the point A, will be increased by an amount P atmospheric, because P atmospheric is applied at a point. So, according to Pascal's law, now the pressure at point A can be written as H rho G plus P atmospheric. If at any one point in an enclosed fluid an external pressure is applied, at every point in the fluid body, we can say the pressure will be increased by the same amount. So now the new pressure will be H rho G plus P atmospheric. And we are going to see many applications of Pascal's law. This is just a basic example I've taken to make you understand how the pressure is distributed throughout the body. It is not necessary that the whole top layer of liquid should be exposed to atmosphere to increase the pressure. Even at one point it is applied, it is distributed throughout the volume. Let's see a few more applications of pressure distribution by using Pascal's law. Let us discuss application of hydraulic forces by using Pascal's law. Here we can see a tube. On one side of the tube, we are having a piston which is fitted into it, having cross-sectional area S1, and the other side of tube is having a cross-sectional area S2, which is also fitted with another piston, and a fluid is filled between the two pistons. Now, say at this piston, say it is piston A and this piston B, we apply a force F1, then in this situation we can state, in this case, the pressure applied on the fluid from left hand side will be P1, and that can be written as F1 by S1. And on the other side, obviously due to this pressure, the fluid will be having a tendency to move toward right. So to keep it at rest, we need to apply a force F2 here, such that the same pressure will be applied on the fluid to keep it at rest. So we can say here pressure P2 can be written as F2 by S2. Now in this situation, if either of the forces is removed, like for example, we remove F1, then this piston will start moving toward left and the same force will be exerted by piston onto the left hand side agent who is supporting the piston. So in this situation, we can directly write the value of pressure P1 must be equal to P2, because inside the fluid as it is horizontal, there won't be any change in the pressure at left end or at right end. So in this situation, if we substitute the values, it will be F1 by S1 is equals to F2 by S2. This implies if we calculate the value of F1, this F1 can be written as F2 multiplied by S1 by S2. So in this situation, if S1 is more than S2, which we can see here, this implies the value of F1 will also be more than value of F2. So if a force F2 is applied on one end of the tube, we can simply state the piston will exert a force F1, which is higher than the applied force onto the other end. Or if at one end a force F1 is applied, in a narrow cross-sectional area, the fluid will exert lesser force, and this concept we call as force amplification, using which a small amount of force can be magnified to a large extent as the value of force which is changing is in the ratio of area of cross-section of the tube in which the fluid is filled. This concept is very useful wherever hydraulic forces are used. And just varying the area of cross-section of the tube in which the fluid is filled, we can change the magnitude of forces applied by fluid or pistons onto the external agencies or different type of mechanism driven by the forces.